Hey guys, what's up? So today I have, oh my goodness, a project to work on, and I hope I can actually make this work. So what this is a 1920s, 1930s atomizer perfume bottle, and it's missing the tube and the bulb. So this is Czechoslovakian glass, and I don't know who the maker was, possibly Moser or another Bohemian factory. And so, okay, you see the tube and the bulb, which is one of these things. And by the way, my friend Laurel from Texas actually sells these, and that's how I get them. And here's her card. I'm going to put a link into the description so you can buy these pieces if you need them for your perfume bottles. So my friend Laurel actually started to inspire me to fix these old bottles up. This is her passion, and she shared her passion with me. And so here's the situation. So this piece right here would have had a bulb attached right here. So I'll show you. So it would have been just like over this spot. And but the problem is that in order to retrofit this, I'm gonna have to take a pair of pliers and pull this piece off and then push up and try to like fit and stretch this bulb over this little nipple. Now I don't feel like doing that. So what I'm gonna try to do is try something else first. I'm going to try to screw this piece off, and Laurel had given me some parts, and I'm going to try to screw this one and see if it fits into this little collar here. So then I can attach the whole entire bulb and tube to the atomizer instead of just the bulb. I like the look of having the whole entire thing attached to it like that. So let's see if I can get this done. If not, I'm going to have to do the old retrofit and attach the bulb to that spot. So stay tuned and let's see if I can get this little project on the ground and going. So this little piece, it was easy to screw right off. So now we just have that little collar piece there. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to unscrew this center piece that Laurel gave me, and I'm going to try to see if it'll fit and screw into this spot. Let's hope. Okay, so sadly, this piece does not screw into the collar. Now I have plan B. Let me go get plan B. So this is plan B. I found this old atomizer connector with the tube and the bulb on eBay, and I'm going to see if I can get this to screw in. Cross your fingers for me. So now we're off to plan C. That doesn't fit in there either. So I'm going to have to do the old retrofit and actually pull one of these bulbs off with the pliers and carefully so I don't destroy it. Because if I rip it, that's the end of the bulb. And then try to fit that bulb and stretch it over this little nipple. All right, let's see if we can get that done. Cross your fingers. Oh God, these projects are so aggravating. So I was able to pull that piece off. Now let's hope I can fit it over that metal fitting. Wish me luck on this too. Good news, guys. I was able to do it. Look at this. Oh my goodness, I'm so excited about this. So the only problem is that the little metal collar piece that held the little straw that makes the perfume come out up through the straw, and when you squeeze the bulb, it actually shoots out the perfume. The little piece of metal was a little bit bent, so I couldn't fit the straw that Laurel gave me. I guess that's what you call it, or the like the little plastic straw. I couldn't fit it in there. So what I can do to get this working again is take a Dremel with a very, very teeny tiny drill bit and make that little hole slightly bigger to stick that little plastic straw in there, and it will be completely working. But look at this, guys. So now we got the bulb on there. I retrofitted it onto the piece, and this is actually the way it was supposed to be, not with the long tube hanging down. But I just love it. Oh my goodness, I love it so much. Look how pretty this is. And it has a beautiful hand-painted enamel going throughout the piece. And it's actually a gorgeous shade of amber. My guess is this was made sometime in the 1920s, probably the late 1920s to the 1930s. And again, it's Czechoslovakian. And look at that. Laurel's pieces came to the rescue. My goodness, Laurel, if you're watching this video, once again, thank you so much. Guys, if you need parts for your perfume bottle or have questions, actually, Laurel taught me how to retrofit these bulbs onto these pieces. And if it wasn't for Laurel, this perfume bottle would not be anything. It would just be missing the piece. So, Laurel, thank you. If you're watching this, again, you are a doll. You are an angel. So, I'm going to put links in my description so you can buy her parts. If you have questions about restoring an antique perfume bottle, she's really helpful, and she also restores bottles for people. So you can send in your bottle to her and she'll fix it for you. So here's her card. And I'm going to, again, put those links in the description. And her shop is called the Scented Memory Fragrance Shop. Her user ID on eBay is called GidgetPup5. That's her eBay name. And her eBay store on, she has a store, is called A Scented Memory. And again, the eBay username, GidgetPup5. Laurel, thank you so much. Once again, you are fantastic for helping me on this one. Oh my goodness, I am so thrilled about having this beautiful, beautiful Art Deco perfume bottle. And it looks as glorious as it once did when it was first made. Wow. So long, guys. I'm in a great mood today.